బయోటెక్ ఎండి కృష్ణ మీడియాతో మాట్లాడుతున్నారు, లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం.
Okay, this is from Vaishali. Have you done testing on vaccine against the UK variant? Has it been proven to be effective against the variant?
It's a good question. Just give me 1 week time. I'll be coming on to you. Please note down her number, name, Sheila. I'll send in 1 week the data to you. We are confident it'll work.
No, there are some questions here. Wait. There are questions here. That, yeah, asked again. The Hindu religious. Okay. Yeah. This is from Mr. Jacob Koshi, the Hindu. Would a few weeks from today have generated some efficacy data? Would that have made a big difference to your rollout?
See, Jacob, we as an Indian company, struggling alone. I don't have backup of AstraZeneca. I don't have backup for Pfizer. I don't have backup for Oxford, all those things. Okay? Country is going through a problem. Country going to problem, and so many healthcare workers are dying. We are not recognizing that, and so many people are innocent people are dying. When a vaccine emergency license is allowed in India after phase two, if it is a proven platform technology. So I want to tell you, Koshi, very simple. Chimpanzee adeno mRNA has not proven efficacy all this time, so they have to do the efficacy trial because the new vector, new mRNA technology, new technology. So they have to do the efficacy trial. Ours is a proven platform. But again, I'm not denying that we don't want to do efficacy trial. It is undergoing. We'll have data in February. But when I have a gazette notification, 2019, it gives me a right to get emergency license after, if it's a proven platform technology, good immunization, immunology, and good safety profile, good, good animal challenging studies. If you have 4 or 5 data points, when I'm eligible, why not? I'm asking same question to you. Why is my other Indian company has got only 100 people immunogenicity data, only 1,000 people safety data? They can get emergency license. Why not me? Thank you, Koshi.
This is from Mr. Mudur. Will there be a continued efficacy monitoring, and who will be doing this?
Oh, we'll be continually monitoring on this one. Equa, which is a Quintile multinational company. Equa is a difficult for me to say that word. I don't know why they named the company.
Yeah.
Equia. Sorry, I have a problem saying that word properly. Equia. Originally, it's a Quintile earlier. Now they call Equia. It's Americans have acquired that company. So they are doing the trial. They'll be monitoring this. And we have the whole next 12 months is going to be monitoring on that patient. So you'll be trust assured is a third party independent review.
This is from Mr. Prasad, Deccan Herald. DCGI said the vaccines are 110% safe. What is the safety assurance that you would give on Covaxin?
Prasad, I mentioned you, we are less than 10% adverse reaction in the beginning itself, one of my slides. Whereas other vaccines, 60 to 70% adverse reaction. I told you, AstraZeneca vaccine, UK vaccine, they're given paracetamol, 4 grams vaccine, along with the vaccine. They're given a vaccine, given 4 grams of paracetamol. That means to suppress the adverse reactions, not to report. Whereas, we have not given any paracetamol to any of our volunteers. Every volunteer who has got any adverse reaction, let them report, honestly. We want to capture, in a normal situation, what will happen in a vaccine. Because in a public health system, I can't give a paracetamol to everybody and give a vaccine. I can't do that in a public health system. Here, we have captured real time without any medication. So our adverse reaction is 100%, less than 10% in terms. So we are, I can tell you, we are 200% safe vaccine in the world.
Okay, this is from Nivedita Bhattacharya, Reuters again. A shortage of volunteers for phase 3 trials. Can you talk on that?
Yes, Bhattacharya. I think, you know, we have a media, very active media. Okay. So we have regulators in this country. DCJ is only one regulator. We have a 1 million media and TV channels monitoring our regulator as a regulators. And even smallest adverse reaction in Patna is reported all over the country. And one adverse reaction is enough to reduce my recruitment. But fortunately, with all this help still, we are complete out of 26,000. As on today, 24,000 is completed. So we are only 2,800 people has to be recruited, which we might complete in next 2-3 days. In 2-3 days, we'll be completing that entire 1,800. So we still, just imagine, this country has never done a clinical research of this magnitude. It's a, we are the, you know, showing the trend in the country. We are showing the trend, how it can be done in this country still, with all the problem. We still can do the efficacy trial with so many volunteers. We are doing that. And it's a role model for to other scientists, other startups in this country to follow that. Thank you, Bharat.
This is from Ms. Isha Trivedi of ET Prime. In the presentation, you mentioned phase 3 trial readouts will be between March and October 2021. Can you please elaborate on that?
See, this is a good question. Even Pfizer, Moderna, Oxford, they only declared interim data. The full clinical trial is still going on. Full trailer. So as soon as they get to 140 people, we, you know, we declare the effectiveness and then still follow the trial, continue. So until everybody has to be followed whole year. Am I right, Krishma? So whole year we follow them. 12 months follow up. That's a requirement.
This is a question from Mr. Leroy. He's asking about the interim milestone, 146 COVID-19 cases, like how Pfizer had 95 out of 170.